No, it just says how much it's using.
Hold on. Well, we'll let it go with all lines out.
All right, we're about ready to go here. Is that better? Can you hear me now?
Yes.
All righty then.
Hey, now or never.
You get your mark for this one?
Hey, thanks everybody for coming out here tonight.
I was trying to live stream it, but it unfortunately didn't work.
Doing the kick
hook? Can you tell if the camera's on now?
Looks like it. Yeah. Looks like the red light's on.
Don't worry about it now, buddy.
Isn't it supposed to be a little red light instead of a big one?
No.
Tonight, and make sure you socially distance, because we don't want anybody to get sick because of us.
Not from the virus, anyway.
Just like what we got here.
Thank you. Very much. So nice to be back playing again. So even though these guys are the Bluegrass All-Stars, we play all sorts of stuff, and including this blues tune here.
Some insurance on me, honey. 'Cause if you ever say goodbye, I'm gonna
Oh, thank you so much, folks.
Hey, Rito. Hi, Rito.
You mean hi, Grandpa?
Grandpa Paul.
Long black mail, yeah. Bud. You got this, Paul?
Got it, yeah.
You guys want to do a break? You want to do a full break, or you want to do just a split verse kind of break?
Whatever feels right. I mean,
we could do a split break.
Split verse, chorus?
No, just the verse.
Verse, okay. All right.
Are there two breaks in? Or just the one?
So don't mess it up.
One chance. Yeah, one job. Don't screw it up. Stone Valley Bluegrass Band. And we also have Bob Dick from Blackstone Valley Bluegrass Band. And Kenny also plays with Erica Brown. And Bob plays
with Mudchuckers.
Bob plays with
Mudchuckers.
And the Mudchuckers. And Bob plays with a million different people.
And, Slowgrass?
And he also plays with Slowgrass. And also Franny McConville on mandolin, who also plays with Slowgrass.
And Paul Della Valle here.
Thank you.
Plays with the Worcester County Bluegrass All-Stars, the Ink-Stained Wretches.
And Hillbilly Shakespeare.
And the Hillbilly Shakespeare? Hillbilly Shakespeare.
Who is Hillbilly Shakespeare? Anybody know? Hank Williams is correct.
That's
not fair though, George, because you're in Hillbilly Shakespeare, so you can't answer.
Well, Paul asked me to sing this next one for you. This is an old band tune. I picked it up from the Gibson Brothers, Bluegrass Band. The Bluegrass sized it. Oh, I think I'm cutting in and out here. But.
By the way, if we make any mistakes tonight, which, you know, we'll make plenty, it's COVID's fault.
Sorry, it affects everything, even your fingers, vocal cords.
We had virtually no rehearsal.
As opposed to no rehearsal virtually. We had one of those too.
Paul sent a list, and there we go.
All right, this next number is called Ophelia. 2, 3.
So here's a sad song that I wrote about a woman, and they're all about women.
cry. But darling, please believe me, 'cause it's true. I'll mean it when I say goodbye to you. You can break a good man's heart so many times, then his blood grows thicker like most fine wine. We will never share the good life we could have when only one's in love. It's always sad. You go away. It seems you always wanna fight. When you come back, you say you're going to stay. But we both know things still ain't right.
I wouldn't leave. Just another promise I didn't keep.
can't help me now. I'm in too deep, there's no way out. And it looks like I have really led myself astray. Runaway train, never coming back. Wrong way down a one-way track. Seems like I should be getting somewhere. Somehow I'm neither here nor there. Can you help me remember how to smile? Make it somehow seem worthwhile. How on earth did I get this jaded? Life's mysteries seem so faded. But I can go where no one else can go. And I know what no one else knows. Here I am just standing in the rain. With a ticket for a runaway train. Everything seems cut. Touch a little insane, just easier than dealing with the pain. Runaway train, never coming back. Wrong way down a one-way track. Runaway train, cursing through my veins. Runaway, but it always seems the same.
Separately.
By ourselves.
Franny said a joke, but there's little kids here, so.
Without masks on.
Della Valle original song here. Paul, I'm wondering if today, if you have brought any CDs to give away with your famous questions, trivia, bluegrass trivia questions, or just general trivia.
I brought two, actually. They're in the car, but I will get them
Stay tuned.
So, one of the questions, well, we won't ask it yet.
Yeah, why don't we wait till we have a CD?
And I need to know that you have to tell me the answer to.
he's gonna ask a question and then I have to verify. That's interesting.
Bluegrass Encyclopedia.
But I know you know the answer. I know you know it.
Okay. Yes. 2 + 2 = 4. I'm good at that one.
Sometimes. Okay. So, Muddy, tonight when I saw you with that mask on, I don't know why, but my mind flashed on when you got bit by the horsefly and your whole face went whoop. I had a picture of that for a long time. I don't know if I still do.
That's nice to know.
Yeah, it's a weird picture to keep, you know.
Well, she was swimming and she went down and came up and a horsefly bit her forehead and her face just went whoop.
Ouch.
Yeah, it was exponential growth for all you math majors.
That's a big word. That might be, you might want to put that in English class, too.
All right, so this is a song I wrote. It's called Blessed. Oh, by the way, at the end, we'll just play out. We don't have to do the, because then nobody knows when to clap if I do the slow down again.
Okay.
So many summers ago, we were somewhere out west. A star fell from the sky. You said we were blessed.
Driving on, still driving on.
used to always end it with, I'd sing that first part with the a cappella part, but then I realized that nobody knew when the song was over then, so they just all sit there and look at me.
Well, it's easy, you just say,
that's
we're
it,
done.
Folks.
Clap now.
I can do like Porky Pig at the end of the cartoon.
That's all, folks. Yeah, we're kind of figuring this out as we go, as you can see.
Remember that for next year, note that.
Okay, this is another song I wrote, and after that we won't do another one for a little while. All right, now Bobby's gonna sing us a song. But, hold on one second. I need to get my,
Are you going to get your encyclopedia?
I gotta get the media prize. I mean, the prize.
What
do
you get?
Okay, tell some joke, Bobby.
Yeah, we'll just run right into this song. This is a tune by Lester Flatt, Earl Scruggs, and the Foggy Mountain Boys. Classic bluegrass time back in the 1950s. Hope I haven't given away the answer yet, Paul.
Anyway.
In what decade did the...
Paul has arrived back at the stage with prizes in hand.
This is our first record album or CD. I guess they don't make record albums anymore, and these guys are all over it, and so whoever comes up with the correct answer first will win this prize. And the question, I have to check to make sure Bob knows the answer first, is then I'll ask it. Okay. This is a tough one.
Next question.
Who was Bill Monroe's, the father of bluegrass, who was his first banjo player?
Nope.
That's what I thought. I had to check with Bob. Not the correct answer. But you might win one anyways.
No, actually, Earl Scruggs joined Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys about 1945 or 1946. The band existed prior to that, and it was really when Lester Flatt heard Earl Scruggs playing, he said, "Ooh, that's an interesting sound, and you need to come and audition with Bill." And so Earl Scruggs came and played with Bill Monroe, and that was really the very first true bluegrass sound, because Earl had a great finger-picking style on the five-string banjo, which previous banjo players in Bill's band did not have. I think Bill's first banjo player was a guy they called String Bean.
Oh, yeah.
And he kind of had a different picking approach. It wasn't that real five-string roll. That's kind of a lousy interpretation of it, because I don't play the banjo, but that was really
the
beginning of bluegrass.
So, the correct answer was string bean, but Harry, you win anyways because you were close enough. So I'm going to throw it to socially distant.
Wow, it almost made it.
He wasn't kidding.
Well, I don't want to hit these nice people here.
If you took it out of the case, it might have gone farther, but.
So yeah, this tune is from Flatt and Scruggs, because Lester Flatt and Earl Scruggs left Bill Monroe's band around, I think it was 1948 or so, 49. And
Mike's
they,
actually on that album.
They
and Chuck.
Created their own repertoire of bluegrass music and became a little more polished sound and a little more business savvy than Bill Monroe was. Kind of burned Bill. He was not very happy about that. They were kind of became enemies for a little while. But they went on to create incredible bluegrass music, including this song here called The Blue Ridge Cabin Home. Oh, longing for days gone.
How are you? You having fun?
It looks like Rocky.
Okay. So we're going to close this set with a song by Towns Van Sant that wasn't written as a bluegrass song, but it's been recorded a zillion times as a bluegrass song. And that's how we're going to do it.
I'm going
out on the highway, listen to them big trucks whine. wine. White freight line, won't you steal away my mind? White freight line, won't you steal away my mind?
Thank you very much. So we're going to take a very short break and go around and shake everybody's hand. Actually, we're not going to do that. But we're going to take a short break and we'll be back with more fun and frolicking.
Stacy, oh, you are. Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh.
Sure.
Yeah.